Again.
My personal project for this year was to study personalities, how they're developed, how they can change, and how they can change. My goal was to create a personality test for my classmates to take and to learn how you can change your personality and even try it on myself. I spent the first semester doing all the research I would need to complete both goals. The first thing I researched was how personalities come from and how they form. They're mental habits we adapt from our environment, important events, people around us, and sometimes we inherit directly from our parents. They are not fixed or solid in any way, and it is 100% possible to completely construct a new personality for yourself. If anyone is interested, I may be able to explain how at the end of this presentation. The second thing I researched was how to properly construct or write a personality test, and then created a long list of drafts until I wrote my final one. Once my classmates were given the test, filled it out, and returned it to me, the rest of my project revolved around gathering data on the results to see if I could deduce where their personality was developed, but most importantly, to gather statistics, share as the main presentation as my work. I'm now going to share some of these statistics with all of you. One of the first questions I asked, I presented my classmates with a list of 31 words they could use to describe themselves. I asked them to circle all the words they thought applied to them. The words people used the most were strong, artistic, adventurous, kind, open, shy, useful, and athletic. The words people used the least were pessimist, antisocial, secretive, reserved, extrovert, aggressive, afraid, and jealous. Words people never used were leader, weak, and unusual. One of the most interesting things about this part of the test was that people who were friends with each other either had very similar answers or polarizingly different ones. Specifically, people that who I would consider good friends usually had the more similar ones, where people who I know are best friends with each other we usually tended to have the polarizingly different ones. The second piece of info I gathered was that there was a direct link between having overwhelmingly positive things to say about yourselves and not reading the question properly or at all. There was a handful of questions where I specifically asked people to list their flaws so that I could learn more about their self-image. Even when presented with these very explicit requirements, there were students who only had praise to give themselves. When I conducted one-on-one interviews with these students and asked them why, all of their responses were essentially, "Oh, I didn't read the question." In one of the most important questions of the test, I asked about important events that may have changed someone or helped them develop as a person. I noticed that there was a very big difference between how male and female students answered this question. Female students tended to read this as a very negative question, listing things like unhappy home lives, losing friends, death, being bullied, and any other either sad or just outright traumatizing events that changed them. When I asked how these events changed them, the resounding answer I got from most students was that it made them more mature or taught them to grow up faster. Male students tended to read this as a positive question and listed things like making new friends, having fun experiences with family members, attending the school was one I got a lot, or they just straight up didn't answer the question at all. Female students also tended to have longer, more explicit, straight-to-the-point answers. Even though I didn't really ask for them, they were very eloquent. Male students tended to have shorter, more abstract answers that usually maxed out at about 2 sentences. The last statistic I gathered is that literally only one person in this entire class has any idea for what they want to do with their lives in the future. Any questions?
Who was that person?
Who was the person that has their life plan? It's Leia.
Really?
Yeah, you're the only one.
Of course, yeah. It's Leia.
Anyone else?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
How did I do?
I'm supposed to keep answers a bit private. I will say, one of the statistics people laughed at more had a lot to do with you.
Oh, yeah. Hey, wait, was one
okay, any other questions? Bodhi?
Okay, so during your time in Boston for the whole year, have you noticed anyone's personalities change, like, through this year?
Oh, Kellogg's pointing at you, but I honestly don't agree. I don't think I've seen you change, but I've seen you open up a lot and become a lot more comfortable around us. You were very shy at the beginning of the year. Then, there was someone else who I noticed. Who's one? Kayo. You also opened up a lot more. Okay. Any other questions? No?
Oh,
yes?
I didn't tell us.
I know. You didn't. turn it in.
I can see, like,
no, you can't.